having an interaction between people and the archive itself allows me to use my specific skill sets and research to complement the archive and to contribute to the archive and say, this is something that you might find interesting. This is something that you can use to highlight diverse histories in your own collection. My research focus is Black British history in the 18th and 19th century, focusing specifically on women. Having so many images at my fingertips and being able to compare and analyse various images at the same time, so then I can start to really dissect the details in the portraits and how those representations have been constructed and who constructed them. That in itself is kind of the first step to really seeing Black women rather than just being aware of their presence. And that is important in engaging with their histories as women, as human beings, rather than as kind of abstract ideas. Obviously, Black people in these portraits would have been used to complement the subject or the figure, and they would have been used in the same way as pets or as fruits, as ornaments. And having that perception of them, we do get variations between households. So we see images that contrast in the level of jewellery that they would have been wearing, or how the images of exoticism were kind of evoked with their presence in the portraits. The tiny details are really significant in the research process because there's so little about Black women that any detail can open a new avenue of research. We don't necessarily know if every Black person we see in a portrait is a real Black person, and whether that person was perhaps a fabrication or perhaps someone that the artist saw once in their life and decided to recreate in the image, or perhaps if they were actually sitters in the portrait. When you head down this research avenue, you often come to a lot of stumbling blocks precisely because we don't have necessarily the records to complement that image and really investigate whether that person was real or just an imagining.
But like details like this is like a mostly, there's a lot of men in this photograph, but then there is the slight woman in the corner there who has like details and headdresses on that could indicate where she's come from in Africa or precisely who she was before.
They don't necessarily pay attention to the details of skin colour, of physicality. There are a lot of images that I've come across where you can't necessarily tell if a person is a man or a woman, and you can't necessarily tell where that person comes from, and so there's so much ambiguity behind so many of the images. And so the search becomes difficult. As a society, we've become much more conscious of race and conscious of derogatory terms, but those terms are still inherently rooted in the history of these images, precisely because they're in the names. And so we have to rethink how we engage with those terms and how we still ensure that the history is present, but we're not perpetuating colonial ideas of inferiority and negative histories that have placed Black people as other, as different.